Oh, we can go right through. I didn't even... Okay, cool. I guess one of these is the generator. Probably this big one.
A relatively small machine full of electronics with a glass port on the front.
A port?
A large machine with lights cycling on its front side. An impressive-looking machine of alien manufacture.
Nice. Alright, what do we got here? This is exciting, all the unknown and stuff. Look at that thing that keeps
filling. It is a powerful transmitter, unlike anything in Starfleet records.
You know, and this little thing that, like, comes back and forward over there.
It is a scanner with both long-range and detailed capabilities.
So this is a scanner, this is a transmitter, and this is... generator?
It appears to be a detection device. Judging by the complexity of its circuitry, I would gather that it is quite sensitive.
Hmm. So nothing in here is obviously a... well, a generator. You had anything, Bones?
There's something triggering this darn thing, but it seems too little to get a good reading.
Really?
It's like there's something inside the tricorder tickling it.
So it's reacting to our scans with the tricorder. Interesting. Can we do anything with this stuff?
I am fairly certain it is a transmitter of some type, Captain. While the construction and circuitry are totally unfamiliar to me, I do notice a lack of signal focusing or the ability to go omnidirectional or any other similar change. However, the system is slaved to track to a general sector of the galaxy. Information is passed following a random signal pattern with the lead pulse carrying the coding keys.
English Spock, please.
That was English, Captain.
Thank you,
to
Kirk.
To rephrase, the signal is permanently directed to one area of the galaxy.
That was
an area
English, Captain.
I believe the Federation has yet to explore. The signal beam is not tight enough to fix an exact planet or even a specific system. These settings cannot be changed.
Then this is a sort of monitoring system only?
Quite possibly. Furthermore, the signal frequency is 0.00052 angstroms, and the transmissions are coded. Captain, unless someone was looking for this signal in particular, chances are it would be dismissed as background radiation, cosmic rays.
You learned all that by just playing with the console on a machine you've never seen before?
I am the science officer, Doctor, and a Vulcan.
True that. Saving the big one for last.
As I assumed earlier, this is a scanning device. The architecture is quite interesting and quite elegant. Captain, whoever constructed this is probably more technologically advanced than we are.
And taller. Look at how high the console is.
Good observation, Bones.
Thank you, Jim.
But not necessarily correct. It is logical to assume they do work at a higher level, however.
Are you trying to say their hands come out of their heads, Spock?
I am not assuming they have hands, Doctor.
Tentacles? And now, the big kahuna.
A sensor device, quite sensitive. This system detected the geological scan from the Demeter. Chances are good that it had already detected the Demeter's presence.
Then why not scan the Demeter immediately?
That would have certainly alerted the ship to the presence of this equipment. Whatever or whoever controls this waited until its detection had already occurred.
Well, so we can't decide how we want to pronounce the name of that ship. Can we do anything with anything? Are we accomplishing anything?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Not thinking it's necessary. Alright, so... got some wires.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No,
I don't think
that's
necessary. How about a switch?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
And finally, this board of circuitry.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Okay. So when he said that he was taking down a force field on the generator, maybe he meant he was taking down the force field generator. Because this stuff is not generators and it's down. And now I can just go to other rooms without having Spock mess around. It's a beautiful thing. How about here? Nice.
A large computer sits in front of you. In some ways, it reminds you of a reduced version of the historic UNIVAC system.
Oh my god. The UNIVAC computer, I believe? It's like, we have calculators today more powerful than that thing.
Captain, this appears to be a mass storage device. The tricorder cannot tell what information it holds.
Hmm. Yeah.
I'm just a simple country doctor, not a magician. There are some things I just can't fix.
Well, you don't work in the country. And you have not seen the country in quite some time. So, just wanted to see if your tricorder tickled
again.
This
generator may be providing power for more than just this complex. It is broadcasting power, which is causing the interference in communications with the Enterprise. I cannot tell for certain if there are receiving units for this power, because some of the readout circuits are damaged. Fascinating.
What is fascinating this time, Spock? I doubt it's fascinating to either Bones or myself, but I'm sure that won't stop you from telling us. What is fascinating this time, Spock?
Sure.
You tell him, Jim. I'm getting sick of this alien smarter than thou attitude.
Hey.
If either of you had an ounce of logic, you would be more prepared to listen to my information and possibly even understand it.
Well, I asked you.
Ordering on insubordination, aren't we, Mr. Spock?
I always knew that no emotion was just to cover. He thinks he should be in charge.
Mr. Spock, I'll have those findings from you right now.
Captain, it appears the circuit was deliberately damaged. This would only be possible if the force field were down. Who would damage their own machinery? And for what purpose?
More and more curious, Mr. Spock.
Also, Captain, I am able to determine that if power is interrupted rather than shut down from the console, it will send a signal to the discharge unit and release the bacteria into the atmosphere.
Hmm.
Captain, there's a small display active. It appears that this device is a memory unit, an archive. Most amazing. The information is in volatile memory. If power were lost to this device, all information contained within would be lost.
Hmm.
An odd way to create an archive.
What is in the archive?
The displays indicate it contains a vast amount of data on three-dimensional projection. Circuitry diagrams, equipment construction techniques. Essentially, everything needed to project lifelike images in great detail inside of a structure. Starfleet does not have this level of technology. This would be a major find for the Federation.
Then I think that gathering that data would be a very good thing to do, Mr. Spock.
Very well, Captain.
Cool.
Captain, the display indicates that the best view of the projection will be from the south side of the room.
Well, gentlemen?
Huh.
Anyone got popcorn?
Boom.
Popcorn. It's Bones. Kirk. They're all looking at each other, looking all over the place. Kirk's Heine. Spock. Spock Heine. Okay, now what?
impressive spot.
Captain, I'm not responsible for that occurrence. However, I did discover that accessing the memory will not only trigger the shutdown of this unit, it will also send a signal to another device, most likely one somewhere in this complex. Damaging the unit will also initiate shutdown and signal transmission.
There's no way around it?
None, Captain.
What is this, some kind of idiotic test? Don't fool with that, Spock. You'll poison this planet and make these inhabitants permanently aggressive.
Doctor, you do not know for certain that whoever placed the Balcozzi here did not intend for that to happen. The aggressiveness may be what they need to develop further. And the information in the archive is a reward for sending the Balcozzi into the next stage of their development.
You just want to get your Vulcan fingers on that precious scientific information. More like 30 pieces of silver for condemning the Balcozzi to the lives of violence. Jim, you can't let this unfeeling monster do this to the Balcozzi.
Do you wish me to continue attempting Brother. To access the archive, Captain?
Yes, Spock. That information could be critical to the Federation.
It's going to shut down another machine.
Let's hold off until we get a little more information. Yes, Spock. Let's hold off until we get a little more information.
This one. Let's check out other machines before it shuts them down. Whichever one it's going to shut down. In here. Let's go here then. Alright, this stuff.
A huge vat full of pheromone and food-producing bacteria.
Alright, now we couldn't scan this before.
Fascinating. This device siphons material from the other unit by way of the pipe overhead. It possesses the ability to move a substantial amount of material. Most interesting is that the material can be jettisoned up out of these caves into the ecosystem of the planet. It may be that the material in the vat is dangerous, and the builders wished to protect this complex from contamination.
But they didn't care about the planet, did they?
Apparently not the primary concern.
Tell that to the Balcozzi.
According to the studies from the Demeter, the Balcozzi would not recognize speech.
I believe Bones was speaking figuratively, Spock.
There is presently no means by which to shut off this release. The unit is set to discharge, and the control switch has been removed.
Removed? Could it be the builders were not afraid the complex would be contaminated, but were instead afraid the ecosystem would be in trouble if the contents of the vat were not discharged?
Interesting hypothesis, Captain. Difficult to do more than speculate at this time.
Now, originally we were going to have Bones look at it as well, so,
This thing is just full of that pheromone, Jim. We have to be careful. It could ruin the entire planet for the Balcozzi. We would condemn them to a world filled with brutal violence. It would be genocide.
What about this thing?
An orb and disc configured device hangs from the ceiling.
Captain, this is the life support control unit. This is a food-producing unit, Captain. There's a fast-growing bacteria inside. The bacteria is continually being harvested, and units of food are being produced and carried elsewhere by that large pipe. The small pipe next to it carries the byproducts.
That seems simple enough.
There's much more, Captain.
Well, I'm surprised.
Any breaks in any of the pipes will send a release signal to the discharge unit, as will interruption of power to the food-producing unit. Any tampering will send the bacteria into the atmosphere.
Tampering. He said it needed a switch. We have a switch.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Assuming the appropriate signal is received, this unit can be shut down safely. The shutdown signal does not originate here.
Huh.
Captain, the controls are locked out. There is no way to change their settings. I do not believe there is more to learn from the food producing unit.
Okay, what's out here again? That's where the food is. Okay. Maybe it's that other thing that said it would shut down another piece of machinery. Maybe it's supposed to do that. Gonna save just in case?
Save new game. Replace pre-
You don't destroy the world or something like that?
Captain, accessing the archive will cause transmission of the signal from this unit to the other device. Do you wish me to continue?
Yes, Spock. That information could be critical to the Federation.
Go ahead.
I have the data, Captain. The archive is now empty and has sent its signal.
I'm not happy about this, Jim. I think we're dooming the Balcosa to eternal strife, not to mention what it's doing to us.
Spock may have had it right. This might have been the plan all along. Someone obviously set all this up. Would they possibly put the Balcosa in a position to be negatively affected?
Captain, the energy field has dropped enough for us to communicate with the Enterprise.
Kirk to Enterprise. Scotty, are you there?
Captain Kirk, good to hear your voice.
And yours, Scotty. Three to beam up.
Ah. I don't want to beam up yet. I want to see that the device is shut off. I didn't think that was going to happen.
Chekov, set phasers on widest possible setting. We need to sterilize the atmosphere near that complex. We must wipe out that bacteria.
Aye, Captain.
Captain, as we surmised on the planet, there are more bacteria-producing locations. Sensors indicate several similar geysers of material being ejected into the atmosphere from various locations on the planet. My calculations are that we cannot destroy enough of the bacteria to stop it from invading the ecosystem. Captain, the Balcosa will be permanently subjected to the pheromone.
Jim, I've gone over the report. You have doomed the Balcosa to violent behavior and cut their food supply to boot.
Oh, crap.
Jim, with all your years of service, you should know that no information, no matter how revolutionary, is worth condemning an entire civilization. Maybe you and your crew have been together a bit too long. I expect better things from you, Captain. You are hereby ordered to return to Starbase 42 for re-evaluation of your fitness for command.
Oh, crap.
Mr. Spock, you are now in command until you receive further orders.
Load a previously saved game.
Game over. Okay. Glad I just saved that. Okay. We're not messing with this. What was the sense of putting a switch on that device if we can't even use it? This isn't the way.
You see what appears to be a safety valve.
Safety valve.
A discharge unit set to eject material siphoned through sealing pipes into the planet's ecosystem. A discharge unit set.
Can we do anything with it?
I would just be wasting our time, Spock. This is more along your lines.
Where do we put this switch?
I do not believe there's more to learn from the food producing unit.
We need to shut it down.
Captain, the controls are locked out.
Can we attach anything else to this?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. I suppose the question is what to do with this thing.
Oh, yeah. I thought we were going to have an answer. Wait.
I suppose the question is...
Hold up. No...
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
What do we do with this thing?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
On this?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Here?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
How about here?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Or here?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Jim, have you lost your mind? You would condemn the Balcosa to eternal warfare. Plus, there's no telling what effect it would have on us.
Captain, unless we know the exact nature of those controls, I would recommend against shooting them.
Well, we have to do something, dammit. What are we supposed to do here?
Computer, are you on? Maybe I'm not the man for this particular job.
Computer, are you on?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
I bet if I could find a popcorn dispenser, this thing would show us a movie.
You and your popcorn.
The light is provided by the surface of the room.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
This item will not affect the repair this unit needs.
Without a readout in place, what?
This item will not affect the repair this unit needs.
Without a readout. Do something. Solve it.
The readout is now fully functional.
Ooh.
There are other locations on this planet receiving power from this generator. Most peculiar. The locations of these units are not in the database.
And you think they should be?
It would be logical, Captain. But removing the circuit that controls the on and off functions of this device would also be illogical.
Are you trying to tell me that's what happened here?
Exactly, Captain. Until that repair is made, it would be impossible to execute a proper shutdown procedure.
So did we put the card on the thing? What about wires?
The repair is complete, Captain.
Well, that was easy.
It would now be possible to safely shut this machine down. However, doing so would certainly affect all the other equipment in this complex.
Shut it down, Spock. Shut it all down.
Captain, accessing the archive will cause transmission of the signal from this unit to the other device. Do you wish me to continue?
Yes, Spock. That information could be... Let's hold off until we get...
What are we doing? Wait.
Captain, do you wish me to start the shutdown sequence on the generator?
Let's hold off on that for now, Spock.
So that's the generator. I thought it was a computer.
Shut it down, Spock. Let's hold... Shut it down, Spock.
Shut it down, Spock.
Wow. That ends that threat. Balcosa can rest peacefully tonight and from now on.
It is still a trying time in their development, Doctor.
Think of it as an adventure, Spock. Scotty, 3 to beam up.
Cool. Let's see how we did this time. We won't be removed from command. Oh, brother.
Captain, the power source has completed its shutdown cycle. There is no trace of the bacteria or pheromone in the atmosphere.
Hooray!
It would appear the Balcosi are free to choose their own future.
Good to hear, Spock. I know losing a find like that archive has to hurt.
That would be an emotional response.
Of course it would. How silly of me.
Captain, there are two signals being broadcast from the planet. The first is another burst following the same path as the original broadcast. The other signal emanates from nearby the first. It's aimed at us, Captain.
Subject suitable. Testing continues.
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Interesting report, Jim. I think you were right to release the Balcosi from outside influence. Too bad you couldn't retrieve the archive. No one at Starfleet has any idea who was behind all this, or what the testing message was all about. Keep us informed as you find out more. I've got confidence in you, Jim.
I've reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain.
Cool.
I have a few comments.
Sounds good.
I am very pleased with your performance. It was a perfect mission, Jim. Your reputation as Starfleet's best starship captain is secure. Kane out.
Sounds good to me. We're not under review for our performance. Sneak peek in the next episode, No Man's Land.
Captain's log, stardate 6236.5. Following our mission to Balcos, the Enterprise is proceeding to Omega Corvus to probe radiation clouds. We are expecting an uneventful mission.
Message from Starfleet Command.
On screen.
This is a code to emergency, Captain.
Eventful.
Three Federation ships have vanished in the Delphi system within the last month. 3 days ago, we lost contact with the USS Zimbabwe. You are to go to the Delphi system and find out what's happened to our ships. Starfleet out.
Okay, so that's our mission for next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. And live long and prosper.